sometimes important things come in very small packages, such as this sculpture of the Greek slave by Hiram Powers. Hiram Powers was maybe the first important sculptor we had as Americans. And his most famous work is the Greek slave. This is a bust-size version of it. There are two full-size versions, one in the Met, and then another one, I believe, is in the Huntington Library in Pasadena. And it depicts a young woman who's being sold into slavery. America didn't have many sculptors during the mid-19th century. And Powers had studied in the studio of Torvalds and Udin de Christus, and then had learned to carve in marble himself. And his sculpture, when it came to the United States, toured everywhere. And when I say everywhere, I mean everywhere. It was shown in public halls, it was shown in churches. It was a rallying cry, not only for the fine arts, but for Christianity. So this is not the first work that we've had by Hiram Powers. The first one that we had was a sculpture of Jesus Christ that he considered his most important work. He did it in Florence in the 1870s. We had it here for only a few days. And then it was bought by a client and put on view at BYU Museum of Art, where it was for many years. Now it's back in the private collection. The reason why we have focused on Hiram Powers and collected these two works, which is hard to do, it's hard to find them. Not only because carving in marble was so hard that it meant that he created so few works, but because Hiram Powers is really, historically, one of the most important artists of American history. And we wanted to have something here from him and give our clients an opportunity to see him as part of that ongoing education, that connection to the past that the arch represents and that we hope to foment here at Anthony's.